Hello, bonjour, bonjour, welcome back to my channel. My name is Cyril, I have been a stem cell researcher for quite some time, and this is why I can tell you about the science behind skincare ingredients. And for today's video, we are going to talk about a very famous French brand, which is Bioderma. So in French, it's Bioderma. And this brand has been created in 1977 by a French pharmacist, and his name is Jean-Noël Torel. And the whole philosophy of this brand is about biological mimetism. So the whole idea is to replicate the natural mechanism that we already find mostly in the skin barrier. So personally, I find that this is something that is extremely important because we do have now a lot of research to really understand how the skin barrier works, and the most natural way actually to help your skin is by simply replicating what already happens in your skin and to correct it from time to time. For example, in very dry skin, we know that dry skin are lacking some of those precious ceramides. They have less ceramide than a normal skin type. So a good idea is to have a moisturizer that have a balanced amount of ceramides. But again, if you just look at the lipids in your skin, you have a healthy balance of 1/3 of ceramides, 1/3 of free fatty acid, and 1/3 of cholesterol. And you never find those kind of ratio in skincare currently, which I find is a shame. What Bioderma does, I find the best is really in terms of humectants, because they have, I think it's part of their pattern. They have a different combination of sugar, so it is mainly xylitol, mannose, rhamnose, and also a complex sugar, which is fructooligosaccharides, that you will find in almost all their product, and from time to time they also combine it to glycerin. And if you are not new to my channel, and if you are new, welcome, and consider to subscribe to my channel, you will know that this is an absolute requirement for every single type, because those humectants are going to attract the water in your skin barrier, and your skin barrier really craves this water, and it requires this water to really function. And this is something that you will find in almost all Bioderma products. So the first line that I'm going to review for you is the Créaline line, which is in English and probably in other countries, the Sensibio line. And this is where you find the very iconic micellar lotion. So this bad boy here, and Bioderma was the first brand actually to come up with this cleansing water that are so efficient, especially this one, the one from the Sensibio line, is very efficient at removing makeup. And the way to do it, especially if you have a lot of makeup, is to use a cotton pad, you drench it with a micellar lotion, and then you apply it on your eyes and you wait at least 10 seconds to really infuse all the mascara, the eyeliners, and etc. with the micellar lotion, and then you gently sweep away the cotton pad, but never drag it. This is efficient. What I prefer always to recommend is, of course, to use an oil based cleanser, so an oil cleanser or a balm cleanser. I find them even more efficient and even gentler than a micellar lotion, but they can be very useful when you take a plane. For example, this is what I use to cleanse my skin on the plane. You can also use it at the end of the day. If you wear a lot of makeup and you want to do a sport, you simply use a cotton pad, drench with a micellar lotion to remove the makeup, then apply a moisturizer, and if there is still sun, reapply your sunscreen, obviously. So they can be very convenient also in the morning. If your T-zone is very oily, you can use a little bit of those micellar lotion, but always I recommend to rinse them either with tap water or simply with another toner. The range is also composed of different creams. So the first one is the Tolerance Plus. I have never tried this one. This one is targeted for people who have a lot of allergenic reaction towards, of course, skincare ingredients. So it is a very, very safe ingredient that has a nice blend, again, of humectant, which I really like it. I have never tried it. I have the feeling that it's more targeting for, I would say, normal skin type rather than super sensitive, super dry skin, but I do find that the overall formula is even better than the one from La Roche-Posay, from the Tolerial line, that is also definitely more expensive, and Bioderma is not. If you want to try another one, if you have super sensitive skin, I highly recommend the one from Avène in the Tolerance Extreme line. The emulsion is fantastic and used as a primary emollient squalane. This moisturizer is amazing, even for those of you who don't have super sensitive skin. They also have a declination of three moisturizer. So they have the light version of this one. This is the Sensiblio, the light cream. They have the rich cream that I have over here. And they also have an even more moisturizing one, which they call the Forte, or the Forte in English. So I really like this moisturizer. It is a basic moisturizer that again features those sugar. This one used as the main emollient mineral oil that is almost an occlusive, while the 41, in addition of having mineral oil, it also has beeswax that, if I'm not mistaken, now is only synthetic, so it is not a harvest from beehives basically. And this is also an excellent really occlusive to really lock in the water. So if you have dry skin, this is the one to choose. The one, the rich one, is more targeting for, I would say, normal skin type. And they have also a lighter version that I didn't try yet, but that seems also promising. So the next range is the CKBio line. I have already done a video about it. I have almost all the product from this line. This is, in my opinion, one of the best line that you will find with Bioderma. So they have, I would say, two moisturizer. They have, three. So I have the cream. So this is this one, that is a moisturizer that is targeted basically for normal skin type, that is again infused with the same blend of humectants that I love and glycerin. And also it has this wonderful blend of Centella Asiatica to help to heal the skin. So in my opinion, if you have to choose, I would go straight away with the CKBio. They also have another very interesting product, which is the pomade, which is a really thick, almost gloopy formula that is also with those Centella Asiatica extract. What I love about it is that when your skin is really irritating, so I'm going to give you a couple of examples. If you have a flu, for example, you blew your nose all day long, you can use this one to coat your nose, to protect it and to heal it. You can also use it on really rough patches, or what I love to do is to mix it with another moisturizer to really adjust the moisturizing effect on the moisturizer, and also had the benefits of the Centella Asiatica. What works beautifully for me is to mix the pomade with a little bit of Sensiblio, the rich cream. In the CKBio line, they also have two sunscreen. They have a sun cream for the face and also the stick. I love the stick, especially for the lips or the top of my hairs. For example, you can use it during summer for the top of your hands to protect it. This is also a pretty excellent sunscreen. It is a little bit tacky and also a little bit greasy because it is in a stick form. So go and check my video if you want to know more about this line. They also have another product, which is a drying lotion that is excellent, that I talk about in this video. So definitely go and check it out. So the next line is the Atoderm line. So this line is a mix for dry skin, basically, or mostly dry skin, for the body and also for the face. So the cleansers are not that great. There is only one that seems very promising, which is the creamy shower gel, I think, that I'm definitely willing to buy and to try it out. This one seems pretty good. They also have two body moisturizer. One is more of a milk that is also pretty promising. And what I love about it is that you have a non-fragrance formula, so which is excellent, but they have one which is the Intensive Boom that is simply magnificent because it contains a beautiful blend of ceramide, which is for especially a body cream excellent. And I will definitely buy this one and try it, and I will keep you updated, I don't know, here or on Instagram. So the next line is the HydraBio line. So this line, like the Sensiblio line, also features this beautiful blend of sugars like the mannitol, the rhamnose, the fructooligosaccharide, and etc., mostly combined with glycerin. So overall, it is, I would say, very promising. But what I really dislike about it is that all the product contains perfume. So they also have a toner, which is this product that I've already featured on my channel, which is an excellent toner that has glycerin, this blend of sugars, like I've told you, also niacinamide, which is likely under 1 or 2 percent, but still it is interesting. But like I said, it has perfume, so I'd strongly discourage you to do the old Hydrobio line, because you are going to have a buildup of perfume, which is definitely something that you do not want. The serum is interesting because it is a blend of those humectants that I've just talked about with a silicone, mainly dimethicone. So if you have oily skin type, this is definitely a great product to replace your moisturizer. But like I said, try to only stick to one leave-on product with perfume, which would be in this case, this serum. They also have 3 different moisturizer, a cream moisturizer, and also a fluid that is also declined with an SPF, which is an SPF of 30. I do not recommend it because it is not enough. I only recommend SPF 50 plus, no matter your skin color. I would say those two moisturizer look overall good, but because of the perfume, I would not recommend it, and definitely go and check the Sensibio line and also the Cicabio line, or even you can mix one of those two. So the next line is the Sebium line, which is targeted for acne prone skin. So definitely if you have moderate to severe acne, I would not recommend you to try one of those products to target your breakouts and etc. But go and see a dermatologist. Don't try and seek any advice from any bloggers like myself without consulting a proper dermatologist, especially if you have acne scars. If you pimple leave scars, you absolutely need to see a good dermatologist. And if you are not happy with the treatment, and if the doctors is not able to explain you how the treatment goes and etc., just change and go for a new dermatologist. But you do need medical advice. I will, and tell me down below, make probably more videos about acne, and I would say what product can goes along with the dermatologic treatment. So tell me down below if you're interested to see this. So this line focuses on zinc, on gluconide zinc, which is an excellent ingredient for acne prone skin, salicylic acid, which is a BHA, a beta hydroxy acid. So this is this type of acid that is able to solubilize in the fat, and that also is going to exfoliate the inner part of the pore, so basically it's going to declog the pore. And salicylic acid also has an anti-inflammatory properties. The problem with salicylic acid is the concentration. So the maximum concentration usually found is 2%, which is, I would say, just okay, but in general you will not have any amazing results from it, unless you have super mild acne. But in general, it doesn't work properly unless if it is combined with a strong AHA like glycolic acid. And they do have a night Sebium, I think night peeling, which has 15% of glycolic acid. That is very promising, and this product you can definitely try it. Be careful because it has perfume, so try to use it twice per week to 3 times a week, maybe to even 4 times a week depending on your skin type, but don't over exfoliate. Also, when you are starting using an AHA like glycolic acid and you are acne prone, you will have a purging effect, which is something that is completely normal and you will have to cope with it. But don't stop using the product thinking that it makes you break out like crazy. Another product from this line that it might worth a try is the Global Serum, and also forgot to mention that they use also Bakuchol in this Global Serum. And Bakuchol, there is I think only one report to show that it also helps with acne. But overall, don't try all their product because it can it contains perfume. Even the micellar lotion that they have contains perfume, so go with the one from the Sensibio line. But if you have acne prone, I do not recommend a micellar lotion, but a proper water-based cleanser for sure. Another line that I'm not going to talk a lot about it is the White Objective. If you want to know more, go to my blog and check my blog post. They have 2 products that are interesting. They have a cleanser that contains a very high concentration of citric acid that I'm definitely going to try, and I will keep you updated about this one. And they also have a peeling that contains glycolic acid. I do not know the concentration, which is So in that case, go with the one from the CBOM line because you know that you have 50% with it. And it also have alcohol in the form of ethanol. And the whole idea is to increase the power of the glycolic acid because the ethanol is going to remove some of the lipid in your skin, and glycolic acid is only soluble in water, and by removing those lipids, the glycolic acid will be even more potent. This is also how professional peeling works. They are diluted in pure ethanols. So those type of peeling, I do not recommend them to use on all year long, but only like for a short period of time to really like target those brown spots. But like I said, I don't know the concentration, so I'm a bit, I would say, so-so about it, and you have better option in the market. Another range is the Matricium. I have a whole video about this product that is simply magnificent, so definitely go and check it. And of course, the last line is the Photoderm line, so the sunscreen line that I'm not going to review today, but this is a pretty interesting line because it is very high protection, which I am all about, and also with a very high UVA protection, which is even better. So I have already done a review on one of the sunscreen, which is the Family Milk over here that I'm also going to link, so definitely go and check it out. So comment down below and tell me if you have any questions regarding this video and Bioderma, of course. If you like this video, please thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and to ring the little bell to not miss any of my new videos. You can also follow me on Instagram. I am Cyril Laurent. I have a lot of stuff over here. I thank you so much for watching me, and I will see you next time. Au revoir. Bye bye.